Hello, everyone, and welcome to another episode of AppSec 101. My name is Andrew Garrett, and I work in product marketing here at Fortify. And I'm pleased to be joined today by Shawn Simpson. And Shawn is the Fortify DAST product manager who has a passion for web inspect. His 15 years as a web inspect developer really gave him an in-depth knowledge of the product that is second to none. He joined the QA team back in the Spy Dynamics days in 2006 on the DevInspect project, as it was called at the time. Shawn told me, back then, testing, then developing an Eclipse plugin to perform static and dynamic analysis, when the JVM could only support 1 gigabyte of memory, was an ambitious project, to say the least. Nowadays, Shawn is motivated by Fortify customers and helping small security teams secure hundreds of apps. And it's my pleasure to introduce Shawn Simpson as our guest today. Shawn, welcome aboard. Glad to have you here.
Thanks for having me.
Absolutely. Well, Shawn, our topic today is going to be centered around API security, and specifically API security attacks. So let's go ahead and dive right in with the basics. Shawn, in your words, what are API security attacks?
Well, API security is really just a subset of application security in general for web apps. You have your traditional attacks that you have to be worried about, things like injection attacks, where you have cross-site scripting, SQL injection, command injection. All of those still apply in APIs, but then you have some additional concerns that are really more specific to APIs. Authentication is a big one for securing an API. There's quite often API endpoints that were only meant for development or QA that may get left in, and those are often unauthenticated. You can have different levels of authentication in an API that can expose risks and privilege escalation. And then there's also the issue of quite often an API is exposing the entire back end of your data. It's, you know, direct access to databases, to objects within your code. And often it's really left to the client, the consumer of the API, to do the filtering and make sure they're consuming the correct data. And that can definitely lead to some additional risks of not, you know, exposing only the data that you want to expose, risking exposing greatly beyond the scope you were trying to expose with that API, and potentially leaking secrets that you don't want to. And then, of course, things like GraphQL, that's opened a whole another landscape of API risks as well. That it's an interesting set of attack surfaces. With that one, you have things like rate limiting, denial of service is rearing its head in a new way. So yeah, APIs, while they're very similar to the traditional attacks, they do have their own interesting flavors.
So let's talk about some of those flavors a little more in depth. You mentioned, you know, exposure and opening up risks, maybe beyond the scope of what you intended to expose. Let's talk about some of those problems and some of those main risks that we see.
Yeah, well, risking exposing data either through not having adequate authentication, or, you know, you may have the authentication there, but you're exposing more of the data than you may want to, or allowing queries to cross domains where they shouldn't. That's really where that data exposure can come from in an API that you quite often don't see in a traditional web app. In a traditional web app, you're kind of protected by some sort of form, or, you know, you have dropdowns, and there's quite often a lot of client-side validation that's going on. And this just doesn't exist typically in an API. We do typically validate APIs, but it's more of validating that the query is logical than that the query is exposing the data in a way that is safe. And that's where you really need a robust security process in place that can think of moving data safely in and out of an application throughout the process of developing the app.
Okay, so when you talk about moving data safely in and out of the app, what are some things that organizations can do to do exactly that and to prevent these types of API attacks?
Well, it all starts with design, making sure that there's a good understanding of the APIs that are being exposed, that the data that the APIs are exposing is safe and that authentication is in place where it should be. Validating not only user inputs, but outputs. When a query or a GET is sent to an API, you can validate too that there is not exposure of information that wasn't intended, and that can really help with that. So that's kind of the first level, is the design review, understanding the scope of the application. Then, of course, you need to start looking at the next level, which is where you're going to do some security scanning of it. You always need to do the full breadth, though, of it. It's not just a one tool will do everything for you. Static analysis very early in the process. As soon as there's code checked in, it's a good time to start doing static analysis to begin looking at all the source to sync type risks. And that's a great way to catch some of those injection style attacks. Once it's at a point where it can be stood up on a server, that's where we want to start looking at dynamic analysis of it. So we can start looking then at the environmental factors, the authentication types of things. It's very hard to test statically authentication because it's a full round trip. It involves an application server as well. I mean, there are some checks, of course, that we can do statically, but this is really where dynamic starts to shine, is those sort of environmental, the things that really require the full ecosystem to be stood up. And then, of course, once we're at the deployment point, if this is a critical app that, you know, if it's connected to a database that has proprietary information, you know, high risk type things, you want to look at having a pen test done, bring in an expert to really look at that holistic entire view of everything. But each one of these steps is critical to actually securing that application.
Yeah, absolutely. And I'm glad you brought up the point of running a pen test as a part of this testing process. Let's take a step back and talk about some other things that businesses can do. You know, when you're building up your AppSec program and you're really wanting to make it as robust as possible, what are some other steps that businesses should take?
Well, having a comprehensive security process in place is critical. For a long time, security was seen as a stage gate. It was, we've developed an app, we're going to stick it on a server somewhere. It's time for security to get involved, and they're going to run their scans, and regardless of what they get, we're putting it up on the server. And a lot of people got hacked because of that sort of thing. You know, it was a checkbox. It was that checkbox mentality of, you know, this is going up, we're going to try and fix some things before it goes up. And, you know, that just doesn't work. The attack surface is more sophisticated, both in being able to find applications and exposure and the type of actors out there who are actually looking for sites to hack. So you have to start early, and that's really in the design process is the first place, thinking about data, how it can move in and out, as we discussed. Looking at the entire breadth of it, when we're thinking about APIs specifically, I touched on it a little bit, but it's important to make a distinction between APIs that are meant for public consumption, whether that be another application or users, and APIs that were put into place because development or QA needed a testing harness. That's quite often done. And it's important to make sure those are cleaned up, make sure those aren't getting out into the real world, because quite often they sneak out there and create unexpected exposure it's not documented anywhere. And that's where something like API discovery can come into place, where we can start taking a look at things like traffic patterns. When we see there's some network traffic that is going, you know, between servers, or actually maybe even in the same application server, it's making requests back and forth. Well, then we're seeing, okay, there's more APIs involved in this than we may have originally thought. And we need to look at those, make sure those are secured as well. Using things like the functional tests that were created by QA and development during the process, running all of those during the security testing and seeing what they expose, because those are probably going to be using some of those test harnesses and APIs that were created. So those are some of the big things that can be done. But it's a lot of it comes down to is understanding the attack exposure of the application, wherever that may be coming from, making sure testing is done early and as part of the development QA security process, and not just left to that stage gate at the end, because you know, the critical and high vulnerabilities that come up, you know, they can quite often require a rethink and of the entire application. And you want to catch those early when it's cheaper and easier and doesn't, you know, necessarily risk slipping the release because of it.
Yeah. Test early and test often, as they say.
Exactly. It needs to be part of the process.
Yeah. Well, let's talk more about that process. So if I'm a developer and I want to integrate some sort of security solution into my process, what solutions are out there?
Well, since we're talking about API security, I think it's important to bring up things like schema validation. Most APIs are going to have some sort of schema, whether it is written before the API or a byproduct of writing the API. Quite often developers, they're not going to sit down and actually write up a schema and then go design their API. They write the code and it generates that schema. And there are some great products out there that can do things like schema validation, and they'll tell if what is expected of the API is really what's going to happen. And I would highly recommend making that part of the process. And then of course, static, dynamic testing, that needs to be an integral part of any sort of web application test, and especially an API test. Some of the things we're working on with API discovery, things like GraphQL discovery, looking at introspection, things like that, we can really take a look at some of the aspects of an API that even a pen tester, they'd have to spend all day, you know, really digging into this, documenting it, understanding it. But you can use some of the tools out there, our tools and others, to make sure, you know, all that low-hanging fruit, all the stuff that can be done in an automated fashion is done and complete and captured and documented. And it can be done early too, so that if you do have a pen tester coming along later, which should be part of the process for any critical application, you know, they can take those reports coming out of Fortify products and others and make it part of their process as well to get that holistic view. And then they don't have to waste, you know, their expensive consulting fees, you know, doing things that automated tools can do already.
Well, Shawn, let's wrap up today with just some final thoughts. Do you have any tips or recommendations or best practices that you would like to leave for our viewers today?
I'd say a mature security process is the best approach to, you know, protecting an organization. That doesn't mean, you know, every company, every group out there has to wait until they have that mature process. It's an iterative journey. So just start thinking about security early. Start by scanning early. Introduce the security team to development and QA, get that communication going, get them used to the products that are chosen to make sure everything is, you know, safe and secure, and then make it part of the process. And you know, you've got to start somewhere. There's many organizations I've been working with now for years that I can remember when they were asking us, what are the first steps? You know, we're looking you know, we know we have a problem, we're looking for help, we're looking for solutions. And now I'm going to these companies because they've created such a great process that I go to them and say, okay, you guys are kind of the poster child to success now. And a few years ago, you know, they were taking baby steps. So I'd say start down that journey to make a secure process, and it'll pay off in big dividends over time.
Yeah, I think that's a great point. You know, every journey begins with a single step, and sometimes it can feel overwhelming when you look at, like you said, some of these poster childs that have these really robust built out security programs. But the fact of the matter is, like you said, just a matter of a few years ago, they were in that same boat where they were the ones that were just taking those first steps. So it really is important to just get started. And then, you know, over time, as your program matures, you can get a little more elaborate in your security program. And I think that's a great point. So, well, thanks again, Shawn. Thanks for joining me. Thanks for taking some time out of your day to speak with me about API security attacks. And to our viewers that are watching this episode, remember to give this video a like and comment down below if you enjoyed it. And as always, don't forget to subscribe to Fortify Unplugged for more great AppSec videos. Thanks, everyone, and we'll see you next time.
Thank you.